Hi everyone, how are you today? I hope you are having a fantastic day. Welcome back to my channel. Or if you are new, welcome to my channel, where you can learn the real-world coding experience. And this is Rohn, the coding expert. I know you are here because either you want to pass the CPC exam or any coding exam, or you want to be a coding expert like me, then you are in the right place. Because I have created this channel just for that reason. If you watch my two previous videos about how to pass the CPC exam, then you should know my tips and strategies by now. However, knowing the tips and strategies alone doesn't mean that you can pass the CPC exam. You got to know your subject matter. In other words, the CPT codes. So in today's video, I will focus more on the surgery and procedure itself, especially surgical procedures performed on the integumentary system, 10,000 series CPT codes first. When we are done with it, next time, we will move on to another body system, for example, urinary system or respiratory system. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the notification button below so that anytime I upload a new video, you will get a notification. Alright, without further ado, let's get started. For those of you who are new to my channel, here's what you need for today's lesson. First, an IC10CM book. I strongly recommend that you use the book that you intend to bring to the exam. Don't forget to tab or bookmark the tabular index, which is the volume 2 of the IC10CM, because that is the only volume that you need for the multiple choice question exam. You are not going to use the alphabetic index, so don't worry about that volume. Second, a CPT manual book, the same idea. Please use the book that you plan to bring with you to the exam and make sure that you tap, highlight, and write notes in the book. So when you come across to that course or procedure, you would recognize it right away, and that will help you to find the course faster. Third, please have a notepad, highlighter, pen and pencil ready, and it can't hurt to have an extra just in case. And lastly is your positive mental attitude, and this will help you to do well. Alright, let's tackle the first case. Case number one. If you watched my previous video about how to pass the CPC exam, you should know my strategy. When you are dealing with surgery or procedure cases, do not read them first. Instead, focus on the first code of each answer. Although in this case, there are not many codes for you to group them, but at least it will let you know how many codes that you have to look it up. Let's find out. B and D have the same code, 10061, so they are in the same group. A and C have different code, so they are in separate group. Now, you can tell there are three codes that you have to look it up, CPT 10060, 10061, and 10041. Please pause the video, open your CPT book and look it up now. I wait for you. Assuming that you already look it up in your CPT book, and here's what you find. 10060, incision and drainage of abscess, carbuncles, suppurative, hidradenitis, cutaneous or subcutaneous abscess, cyst, furuncle, or paronychial, simple or single. Second, 10061. This is the indented code. If you watch my video lesson about CPT format and structure, you would remember the indented code are done for the purpose of saving space. Rather than use the space by retyping all the same information that applies in the parent code, day in Dan Disco. So you have to understand that Disco 10061 includes all the information from the code above, the parent code, except it is complicated and multiple. 10040, acne surgery, mastubilization, opening or removal of multiple milia, comedones, cysts, pustules. Here's the tip for today. Please pay attention. It's very important. Anytime you look up and find a CPD code, I want you to read the code description and highlight the main term that describes the procedure, the surgery, or the test. In this case, this is condition and drainage of abscess, acne surgery, and then the condition or disease, the body size, for example, carbuncle, hidradenitis, abscess, cyst, multiple milia, comedone, cyst, botulism, etc. And finally, the terms that describe the quantity or complexity, for example, simple or single, complicated or multiples. You got the point. This practice will help you identify the main difference between each code. When you know the difference, now is the time for you to read the case, the procedure report. Dr. Smith, a dermatologist, opened and drained multiple complicated acne pustules and comedones on a 20-year-old patient with severe acne. For one of the most complicated acne pustules, Dr. Smith incised, drained, mastubilized the acne cyst by suturing the right and left sides, leaving the cyst open for drainage. What is the correct code for the procedure? Now, you already highlighted the difference between each CPD code and also highlight the key element in the procedure report. I will give you 30 seconds to tell me which CPD code is correctly describes the procedure, and that will be the right answer. Your time starts now. Alright, if you pick CPT 10040, you got it. Congratulations. This is the correct code for this procedure, acne surgery. It also includes the mastubilization of the acne cyst. Code 10060 and 10061 are used for the IND incision and drainage, and it's not in this case, so they are not the right code for this procedure. That said, the correct answer is C, 10040. I hope you get it. Let's do the next case. This case is very straightforward. A, B, C, and D all have different codes. 157A1, 157A0, 157A6, and 157AA. So all you need to do now is open your CPT book and look it up to find out what they are. Please pause the video and do it now. I wait for you. Assuming that you already look it up in your CPT book and hear what you got. 157A0, derma abrasion, total face, for acne scarring, fine wrinkling, rhytis, general keratosis. You see, I highlight the main term that describes the procedure, the surgery or the test. 157A1, identical segmental face, This is another identical, so it includes all the information from the pairing codes 115780, and the only difference is that it's done segmentally instead of the entire phase. 15786, abrasion, single lesion, keratosis, scar. I also highlight the main term that describes the procedure or the surgery. 157AA, the same practice. I also highlight the main term for the procedure, chemical peel. After you highlighting all the main terms and know the difference between each code, now is the time for you to read the procedure report. Dr. Smith, a dermatologist, is seeing a patient for an acne surgery. Follow up, that's what performed 10 months ago. The surgery was successful and the patient's skin condition had rapidly improved due to a strict hygiene regimen and the acne medication. Today, the patient stated that he would like to reduce acne scarring by having dermabrasion on his entire face. Although the patient requested the entire face, the dermatologist only performed the dermabrasion on the area on the patient's face that were not currently prone to acne breakouts. What is the correct code for this procedure? Now, you already highlighted the difference between each CPD code and also highlighted the key elements in the procedure report. I will give you 30 seconds to tell me which CPT code is correctly describing the procedure, and that will be the right answer. Your time starts now. If the answer is 157A1, congratulations, good for you. This is the right code for this procedure, segmental phase. 15780 is not appropriate because it refers to the total phase, which is not in this case. The dermatologist only performed the dermabrasion on the area on the patient face that were not currently prone to acne breakdown. In other words, it's not performed on the total face. 157A6 and 157AA are not the right codes based on what you highlight. These codes refer to abrasion and chemical peel, which are not in this case. That said, the correct answer is A, 157A1. If you like what you have learned so far, then please pause the video. Click the subscribe button, the like button or share button below now, so that more people like you who want to learn medical coding, and especially those who could not afford for a formal class or school, would have a chance to see this video and learn for themselves. If you do this, it is considered an act of kindness. A simple click to like the video, just like to say thank you to a cashier at a coffee shop who just hands you your coffee, even you have to pay for it. Having said that, if you could not say thank you to appreciate any YouTuber who spend their time to make a helpful how-to videos on anything or any subject, then believe me, when you are at work, nobody will appreciate your hard work. And as a result, it's very difficult for you to advance your career. Don't do it for me. Do it for yourself. You can take it or leave it. Let's move on to the next case. Case number 3. This is another straightforward case. A, B, C, and D all have different codes. 10060, 11760, 11765, 11750. There are total 4 codes to look up, so follow my step. Please pause the video, open your CPT book and find this code. I wait for you. Assuming that you already look it up in your CPT book and hear what you got. 10060, incision and drainage of abscess, carbuncle, cyst, furuncle, or paronychial, simple or single. Don't forget to highlight the main term that describes the procedure, incision and drainage of abscess. 11760, repair of nail bed. 11765, wet excision of skin of nail fold for ingrown toenail. I also highlight the procedure. 11750, excision of nail and nail matrix, partial or complete ingrown nail, permanent removal. The same technique, highlight the term that describes procedure. After you highlighting all the main terms that describe the procedure or the surgery, and know the difference between each code. Now is the time for you to read the procedure report. When I read it, please focus on what you think you need to highlight, because when you are in the exam room with the highlighter, you have to do it yourself. A 50-year-old male presents to a podiatric office with complaints of recurrent problems with an ingrown toenail on his right rectum. He has been treated multiple times with antibiotics, but the pain and swelling is causing him difficulty wearing his work boot. He currently does not have an infection, although the ingrown toenail is present and painful. The doctor performs a wet excision of the skin of the nail fold to his right rectum. Which of the following codes should you use? So what do you think that I should highlight? How about you? I hope that you will be very close to mine. Now, you already highlight the difference between each CPT code and also highlight the key element in the procedure report. I'll give you 30 seconds to tell me which CPT codes incorrectly describe the procedure, and that would be the right answer. Your time starts now. If your answer is 11765, wet excision of skin of nail fold for ingrown toenail, congratulations again, you're on the right track now. 11765 is the right code because it is the only code that describes the wet excision of the skin of the nail fold, which you already highlight on the procedure report. That's it, C is the correct answer. I hope you got it. All right, I know you're fired up now, so let's bring it on. Case number 4. This is another straightforward case. A, B, C, and D all have different codes. 11720, 11730, 11740, and 11750. There are total 4 codes to look up, so follow my step. Please pause the video, open your CPT book, and find these codes now. I wait for you. Assuming that you already looked them up in your CPT book, and hear what you got. 11720, debridement of nails by any method, 1 to 5 nails. Don't forget, to highlight the main term that describes the procedure. 11730, avulsion of nail plate, partial or complete, simple, single. Again, I highlight the procedure and any term that describes the quantity or complexity. 11740, evacuation of subungual hematoma. Again, I highlight the main term that describes procedure. 11750, excision of nail and nail matrix, partial or complete, incurable toenail for permanent removal. After you highlight all the main terms and know the difference between each code, now is the time for you to read the procedure report. A 9-year-old girl comes to her pediatrician office after smashing the nail of her right second digit in the car door the previous night. This morning, the tip of her finger is edematous. There is a large amount of ecchymosis present, and the pain is worse than when the injury initially occurred. The pediatrician used a disposable bovine high-temperature cautery pen to cauterize a hole in the nail to allow the subungual hematoma to drain. So actually, this describes the procedure. That's why I had to highlight it. A small amount of serosanguineous fluid is removed and pain rapidly decreased. Which of the following codes should be used? Now, you already highlight the difference between each CPT code and also highlight the key element in the procedure report. I'll give you 30 seconds to tell me which CPT code is correctly describing the procedure, and that would be the right answer. Your time starts now. If your answer is 11740, evacuation of subungual hematoma, you are correct. Congratulations again. Nothing can stop you now. 11740 is correct because the subungual hematoma was evacuated by using a bovine pen to cauterize a hole in the nail to allow it to drain. 11720, and 11750 are not correct because no debridement, no avulsion, and no excision are done on the nail. I hope you get it. That said, the correct answer is C, 11740. I hope you got it right. All right, let's do one more case. Quickly scan into the case, you can recognize this case is related to lesion excision, so here's my second tip and strategy for the day. If you didn't watch my video lesson about how to code lesion excision, then I strongly recommend that you watch that video first before you tackle this case. It'll be much easier for you to follow. Alright, anytime you are dealing with cases related to lesion excision or wound repair, please do not focus on the first code for mid answer and group them as you normally do. Instead, get a piece of paper, divide one column for benign lesion and the other column for malignant lesion. Then you start reading the case and highlight the important elements needed for the correct answers. The physician performed the excision up to 1.5 cm malignant lesion on the patient's upper back. I have to list the information under the malignant. On the back, 2 1.5 cm malignant lesion. During the surgery, the physician noted 4 additional lesions, which looked to be premalignant. These lesion excision were 0.3, 0.7, 1.0 and 1.45 cm respectively. The suspect lesion was sent to pathology lab where they were determined to be benign. What are the appropriate codes for this service? So they are benign, then I have to list them under the benign column. On the back, the first lesion is 0.3 cm, the second lesion is 0.7 cm, the third lesion is 1.0 cm, and the fourth lesion is 1.4 cm. After you done this step, start with the malignant lesion first, so please open your CPT book. You start with the base code 11600, excision, malignant lesion, trunks, arms, legs, 0.5 or less. Then look under this code, you will find the identical for 1.5 cm, which is 11602. So you have to report this code twice because 2 separate lesions. Likewise, for the benign lesion, you start from the base code 11400, excision, benign lesion, trunk, arms, legs, 0.5 cm or less. Then you look under this code, you will find the identical 2 mark, 0.3 cm, 0.7 cm, 1.0 cm and 1.45 cm. And here what you got. Now, you already have all the CPT code lined up properly. I'll give you 30 seconds to tell me what answer A, B, C, or D matches what you have. Your time starts now. If your answer is D, you know it. Congratulations again. Nothing can stop you now. 11400. Here it is. 11401 times 2. 11401 and 11401. 11402. Here it is. And 11602 times 2. Here they are. Congratulations again. Nothing can stop you now. That's it. The correct answer is D, 11400, 11401 times 2, 11402, and 11602 times 2. That is all for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you find this video helpful, informative, and easy to learn with this format, then please give me a feedback by clicking the like button and leave me a comment below just to let me know. I really appreciate it. Until next time, have a great day.